From the Oklahoma newsroom, this is a Varsity Update. I'm Jenny Carlson. ESPN's Outside the Lines came to Oklahoma and put together a piece on the incident involving Cash and Elgin. It's a story that we've been following now for several months here at the Oklahoman, and Jacob Unruh has led our coverage. He's on the phone right now. Jacob, this is an ongoing saga after an alleged incident involving Elgin and girls and the girls' basketball teams. The coach at Cash, Kenny White, allegedly devising a play to throw a ball at the face of Elgin player Gentry Holt, her family taking action to try to figure out what had happened. And ESPN came and they had a chance to talk to a couple of players who gave signed affidavits to attorneys about the incident. When you watched the piece, what did you learn, or what sort of crystallized in your mind? Because like I said, you've been covering this since the beginning. You know it as well as anybody. What stood out to you about the piece?
Well, what stood out to me is that this is the first time publicly that Jimmy Bonerens and Maya Nieto have spoken on the record publicly. They've not really been made accessible up until now. And what I found fascinating about what they said is they stuck to their story. They stuck to what they had signed in the affidavits. Jamie even admitted, I did signal to my nose during the game to signal the play, and now I feel embarrassed about it. I got caught in the moment just following the coach's orders, not realizing what I was doing. And afterwards, I thought, well, that's not right. And that was the biggest thing to me, and the biggest revealing thing to me is that their stories are still the same. The OSSA was supposed to interview Jamie Bonerens Friday to finish the investigation, and I would imagine that her story has stayed the same.
Yeah, and as we know, last week a lawsuit was filed by the Holt family, in large part because the statute of limitations was on the verge of running out, so they felt like, in part, they needed to make sure to preserve some rights there. But now with this story coming out, and as you mentioned, the OSSAA at the end of their investigating of the incident, what do you feel like is next, Jacob? It feels like there's some forward momentum here, but yet this has been a case that's been going on for a while now.
It's really kind of hard to tell. I think the report comes out soon. I would say within the next couple weeks, we'd finally get the report that Cash has submitted to the OSSAA, and the OSSAA's worked with them to complete. I know, the Holt's legal team is kind of leery of the report with OSSAA working so extensively instead of just saying, well, here's the report that Cash submitted, trying to finalize it. But I think, the OSSAA works with schools. That's what they're doing. They're the school system, athletic-wise. So they're making sure that this is thorough, complete, and they want to move forward too. So I think we get that next, and then we go from there. What happens to Kenny White? I don't know. He hasn't been coaching this year. I don't know. I could see, in my head, I might see a scenario where the OSSAA says he's done coaching this year, he hadn't coached this year, and then maybe he can come back with some proper steps in the future, or they could extend something, I guess. I don't know. And they're still, last I've talked to them, they're still unclear what exactly they can do in this situation. But I think the next step is let's get the report and see where to go from here.
Yeah, lots of loose ends yet to be tied up in this incident. Obviously an unfortunate one that we'll be covering until the end. Be sure to stay with the best coverage team anywhere at newsok.com and every day in the Oklahoman.